Hello, good afternoon class. So for our topic for today, the skeletal system. So the skeletal system is composed of body bones and associated ligaments and tendons, as well as cartilages. So the functions of the skeletal system, so we have five. Number one is support the bones of the legs, pelvic girdle, and vertebral column support the weight of the erect body. So, this is the bone. This is the pelvic area. You can see the pelvic area. This is the pelvic girdle. This is the center of the body, or center of the pull of the gravity of the body. So the mandible or the jawbone supports the teeth. This is where the mandible supports the teeth. And other bones support various organs and tissue. So the skeletal system also protects the vital organs. So sample of this is the skull. It protects the brain. Ribs and sternum or breastbone protects the lungs and heart, and the vertebra protects the spinal cord. So other function is movement. Skeletal muscle use bones as levers to move the body. It also serves as a reservoir for minerals and adipose tissue. So 99% of the body's calcium is stored in the bone, and 85% of the body's phosphorus is stored in the bone also. So adipose tissue is found in the marrow of certain bones. So specifically, what kind of marrow? Yellow or red bone marrow? So the answer is what? Yellow bone marrow. So another function is hematopoiesis, also known as blood cell formation. So all blood cells are made in the marrow of certain bodies. So anong type ng bone marrow? It's the red bone marrow. Mostly present in the compact bone. Okay. Ang compact bone, ang present pala sa compact bone is yung adipose tissue. Sa hematopoiesis, nandyan yung spongy bone, nandyan yung mga red bone marrow. So there are 206 named bones in the human body. So each belong to one of two large groups. So we have two groups: the exoskeleton. This is the exoskeleton. And appendicular. This is the appendicular. The upper limb. And the lower limb. So the exoskeleton forms the long axis of the body, includes the bones of the skull, vertebral column, and the rib cage. So these bones are involved in the protection, support, and carrying other body parts. So another large group is appendicular skeleton. So bones of upper and lower limbs and girdles, shoulder bones, and hip bones that attach them to the exoskeleton. So involved in the location and manipulation of the environment. Next, for our bone classification, we have four types. So number one is long bones. So the example of this is the femur. This is the longest bone in our body. So all bones of the limbs except for the patella, kneecap, and the bones of the wrist and the ankle. So, consists of a shaft plus two expanded ends. So, ito. This is called the shaft area. This is the head of the femur. This is the connection for the patella. So, consists of two shafts and expanded head. So, your finger bones are long bones even though they are very short. How can it be? So, yun. Lahat ng ganito yung itsura. Yan ay long bones. Second is roughly cube-shaped bones. So, yung bong bones natin sa wrist and ankle are considered as short bones. So, we have to memorize. This is the carpal bones. So, as we study, we have to memorize the arrangement of the bones. This is the radius in the ulna. So, dapat lagi talagang tandaan ng radius ay ano siya, proximal or distal. Distal part, diba? So, yung radius, dyan makikita yung ating radial pulse. Yan, papulsohan. So, as we look dito sa ating illustration, so, meron tayong pisiform, triquetrial, triquetrium, triquetrial, hamate, capitate, trapezium, trapezoid, scaphoid, lunate. Yan, tanda natin. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Carpal bones. Another bone classification are flat bones. So, example of this is the sternum. So, it's thin, flattened, and usually a bit curved. So, scapula, sternum, ribs, most bones of the skull. Irregular bones have weird shape that fit none of the previous classes. So, examples of these are the vertebra, hip bones, two skull bones, the sphenoid and the ethmoid. So, itong sphenoid and ethmoid bone, sa inner aspect yan ng ating skull sa loob. So, nandiyan yung mga sinuses natin. So, bones are organs, thus they're composed of multiple tissue types. So, bones are composed of bone tissue or osseous tissue, fibrous connective tissue, cartilage, muscular tissue, lymphatic tissue, adipose tissue, and nervous tissue. So, ang dami palang components ng ating bones. So, ayan, ito sa ating illustration. So, in the compact bone, osteon, this is one osteon. So, lacuna containing osteocytes. When we say osteocytes, anong work ni osteocyte? It maintains the bone. Diba? So, lamellae and canaliculi. So, one canaliculi and lamellae and osteocytes along with the Haversian canal. So, ang Haversian canal nandun yung blood vessels natin and nerves. So, one osteon siya. So, the Boxman canal is the interlinking of the connection between arteries. So, yan. Mapag-aaralan natin ulit yan. Lagi nyo tandaan yung mga bone cells natin. Meron tayong osteoblast, osteoclast. Pag blast, B, taga-buo. Clast, taga-sira. Inintandaan nyo ha. Pag osteoblast nagbubuo, ibig sabihin, it functions to form bones. Osteoclast, taga sira. So, pag madaming osteoblast, maraming mabubuong buto. Pag osteoclast, nasisira yung buto. So, yung yang dito, yang si osteo. Too old na si osteoclast. Kasi tagasira siya. So, ayan. Next natin. So, all bones consist of a dense solid outer layer known as the compact bone and inner layer of spongy bone, honeycomb, flat-like needle projections called trabeculae. So, ayan. Ito, pag in-slice natin ang ating bone marrow sa transverse slice, bulalo look. So, itong covering is the periosteum. Then, this is the part compact bone, spongy bone, and the marrow. So, other term for the compact bone is cortical and spongy is cancellous. So, bone is an extremely dynamic tissue. So, madami siyang mga different types of tissue. So, the relations between the compact bone and the spongy bone. So, close up. Ang spongy bone, meron siyang trabeculae. Yan. Pag in-slice din natin ng transverse, yan ang tsura. Ang mga canaliculi. Sa loob. Yan. So, yan. Kapag sa microscopic natin, microscopic sa view natin, gross view between spongy and compact bone. So, sa spongy, merong trabeculae. Compact bone. Trabeculae. Compared compact spongy as viewed with a light microscope. So, sa compact bone ng rib, nandoon yung ating madaming red. Ito, adipose tissue. So, bone structure is a type of connective tissue. So, it is must consist of cells plus significant amount of extracellular matrix. So, ito na yan. So, osteoblast, bone building, synthesizes and secrete collagen fibers and other organic components of the bone matrix. So, initiate the process of calcification. So, found in both periosteum and endosteum. So, the blue marrow indicates the osteoblast. The yellow arrows indicates the bone matrix they have secreted. So, ayan. Ito pala sila, osteoblast. Produce ng bone matrix. So, next is osteocytes. Mature. So, mature na yan. Kaya old na siya. Mature. Mature bone cells, osteoblasts that have become trapped by the secretion of the matrix, no longer secrete matrix, responsible for maintaining the bone tissue. So, ito na yung mga osteocytes natin. Old na sila. Adult na. Yellow indicate osteocyte classes how they're surrounded by the pinkish bone matrix. So, blue arrow supports osteoblast in becoming an osteocytes. So, from osteoblast sila, maging osteocyte sila. So, meron tayong osteoclast. Huge cells derived from the fission as many 50 monocytes, a type of white blood cell. Sa cells that digest bone matrix is called bone resorption. Itong ang term sa digestion of the bone matrix. Resorption. Resorption is part of normal bone growth, development, maintenance, and repair. Concentrated in the endosteum. So, one side of the cell that faces the bone surface, the PM is deeply folded in the ruffled border. Here, the osteoclast secretes digestive enzyme to digest the bone matrix. It also pumps out hydrogen ions. So, to create an acidic environment that eats away the matrix. So, ayan, ruffled border. So, why do you want the cell eat away at bone? So, yun, because of the bone still growing. So, up until the age of 21, sa mga males and 18 years old sa females, nag-grow yung bone natin. Kaya, very dynamic ang bone natin. So, here you can see cartoon showing of three layer types. Osteoblasts are indicated. So, note the size of the osteoclast. So, compare it to the absorbent. Note the size of the osteoclast compared to the osteoblast. So, and note the ruffled border. Why is there depression underneath the osteoclast? What is the name of the third cell type shown here? What do you think of the tan material represent? So, these are the osteoblasts, the young, produce ng matrix. This is the osteoclast. So, malaki na siya. These are bone matrix. So, the bone matrix consists of organic and inorganic components. So, 1/3 organic, 2/3 now inorganic. So, organic components consist of several materials that are secreted by the osteoblast. So, number one is the collagen fibers and other materials. So, this particularly, the collagen provide the bone with resilience and ability to resist stretching and twisting. So, inorganic component of the bone matrix consists of two salts, calcium phosphate and calcium hydroxide. These two salts interact to form a compound called hydroxyapatite. So, yan, tandaan natin. Calcium phosphate, calcium hydroxide, hydroxyapatite. Bone, also known, are containing smaller amounts of magnesium, fluoride, and sodium. So, this mineral sa bone, its character is hardness and ability to resist compression. So, collagen fibers are longitudinal and cross-sectional in how they occupy space between the black bone cells. Three-dimensional array of collagen molecules lie in staggering arrangement, act as a template for bone mineralization. Bone mineral is laid into the gaps. So, this bone has been demineralized. So, has its own organic component removed. So, yan, na-bend yung bone. Kasi kulang na ng minerals. So, long bone structure. So, the shaft plus the two expanded this. And, so, ito yung head natin. This is the diaphysis or the shaft. The head or epiphysis. So, we have proximal and distal. So, expanded ends are epiphysis. So, thin layer of compact bone covering an interior of spongy bone. So, joint surface of each epiphysis is covered with a type of hyaline cartilage known as articular cartilage. So, yan, yun yung cartilage, yung joint na nakabit sa bone natin sa legs. So, it stretches the bone ends and reduces friction during movement. So, another long bone structure, external surface of the entire bone except for the joint surface of the epiphysis is covered by double layer membrane or periosteum. So, yan kanina nabanggit natin. So, outer fibrous layer is dense irregular connective tissue. So, inner cellular layer contains osteoprogenitor cells and osteoblasts. So, yun. Di ba si blast ang nagproduce ng bone matrix natin. So, periosteum is richly supplied with nerve fibers, lymphatic vessels, and blood vessels. These enter the bone of the shaft via nutrient foramen. So, periosteum is connected to the bone matrix by a strong strand of collagen. So, internal bone surface are covered within the delicate connective tissue membrane as the endosteum. So, covers the trabeculae, spongy bone, and the marrow. So, cavities and lines the canal that pass through the compact bone contains both osteoblast and osteoclast. Dalawa sila, di ba? Si periosteum naman, meron lang siyang progenitor cells in osteoblast. So, other structure ng short, irregular, and flat bones. So, thin plates of periosteum covered compact bone of the outside endosteum. Covered spongy bone within. So, have no diaphysis or epiphysis because they are not cylindrical. Contain bone marrow between their trabeculae but no marrow activity. In flat bones with the internal spongy bone layer is known as diploe and the whole arrangement resembles a stiffened sandwich. Wow. So, bone marrow is a general term for the soft tissue occupying the medullary cavity of the long bone. So, the spaces amid the trabeculae of the sponge bone in layer haversian canal, there are two main types. So, number one is longer. Meron tayong two types, may red and yellow. Kayo na pa minabanggit. Pag red marrow, syempre hematopoietic tissue agad yan. Kapag yellow, yung fats, adipose lang siya. So, red marrow looks like blood but with thicker consistency. It consists of delicate mesh or reticular tissue saturated with immune.